हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज अ कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री। इट्स आल्सो अ चैप्टर विच आर स्टडीइंग विच हैव टू स्टडी इन क्लास 9th। सो कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग चैप्टर समथिंग टेक द इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री। सो व्हाट इज कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री? कोऑर्डिनेट मींस पॉइंट, ज्योमेट्री मींस यू नो एनी टाइप्स ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शंस। सो पॉइंट का प्लॉटेशन, प्लॉटेशन ऑफ पॉइंट एंड ऑल्सो यूजिंग द पॉइंट फाइंड सम कंडीशंस, वैल्यूज, डिस्टेंस, एरियाज and locations. So we have to start the coordinate geometry of class 9th mathematics. First we start, if you know what is this, this is the horizontal axis. This is the vertical axis. Horizontal axis is called x-axis and vertical axis is called y-axis. And they meet at midpoint at O. This is called origin. So x-axis and y-axis perpendicular intersect at a point. This point is called origin. So this whole settlement is called Cartesian plane. Cartesian plane, where in x-axis right side is the positive scale 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, left side is the negative scale 4, y, down is the negative scale according to your need. You can increase the values either in up, down, right, left, that your wish. So these Cartesian plane is divided into four part. First, second, third and fourth. These four part is called quadrant. First quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. So here the point plotations are in fixed quadrant. You know, point is always in form of x comma y. X and y have the unique locations. Abscissa and ordinate. X comma y means x always first, y always second. So if we decide the sign of the first quadrant, that is x axis, y axis, for first quadrant x first then y plus plus, x first then y minus plus, x first then y minus minus, x first then y plus minus. This is a sign conventions for the quadrant. Means you can say if the point 3, 4, minus 3, 4, 3, minus 4, minus 3 comma minus 4, they lie in first quadrant, in second quadrant, in fourth quadrant, in third quadrant. But if we write 0 comma 3, 3 comma 0 or 0 comma 0 comma 3, 3 comma 0 and 0 comma 0. Where the three point lie? You know? If we plot the point 3 comma 4, so you can three comma four, 3x and y 4, they are intersecting the point here, that is 3 comma 4, suppose that A. So 3 comma 4 here plot, what is the plotation of 0 comma 3? X 0 y 3. Y0, X3, Y0. So X3, Y0. So if I want to know 0, 3 is where lie, these not lie on any quadrant, they lie on Y axis. You can say is lie on Y axis. 3, 0 lie on X axis. And 0, comma 0 is that is the this is the origin. So as usual in class 9th, you can plot the point, find the location, sign convention. These are used in class 10th also, but the basic concept. What if I say here 3 comma 4 is distance from x axis, that is 4. 3 comma 4 is distance from y axis, that is 3. This is 3 and this is 4. So you have to see, if we find the distance from x axis, that is the value of y. Distance from y axis is the value of x. Opposite. It only understanding when you see the figure. Distance from x axis, this line, vertical line, value of y, 4. Horizontal line, value of x, that is 3. So what we have to conclusion? Origin coordinate 0, 0, point lie on x axis, x, 0, y coordinate 0, point lie on y axis, x coordinate 0. Distance from x axis of point x, y is equal to y. Distance of this point from x axis, value of y. Distance from y axis of point x, y is equal to value of x. They all are the basic rules you have to use in class 10th. Pause the video and note down. Then we proceed the first topic of class 10th. Distance formula. What is distance formula? You know the meaning of distance. If I say any point A, that is x1, y1, and any point B, that is x2, y2. So the distance between them, A and B, that is D. So you can find the value of D by using distance formula, that is x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square. Or you can write x2 minus x1 whole square, y2 minus y1 whole square, both the formula same. Either you can take x1 first, either you can take x2 first. But many students write x1 minus y1. So it's wrong. x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square in whole square root. How you get this formula? Let's see the basic rule. If I say this is the point A, x1, y1, B, x2, y2. That is the distance D. If I say, complete the figure by parallel line drawn, A, B, minus suppose that P. So that is x-axis, x1, that is x2. That is y1 and that is y2. If I say these are parallel lines, so this form 90 angle. So in triangle ABP, angle P 90, so using Pythagoras theorem from class 7th, AB square is equal to AP square plus BP square. Hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square, or base square plus perpendicular square, that your wish. You can change the place because the positive sign, so you can interchange either the perpendicular first or the base first. So what's the value of AB? That is D square. AP, from this to this, so whole minus this part, x2 minus x1. Same BP, whole minus this part, y2 minus y1. Put here AP, x2 minus x1 whole square, y2 minus y1 whole square. So D, send square root to opposite side, plus y2 minus y1 whole square. This is the distance formula to find the distance between two points, where these two points form of x, y coordinates form. So pause the video and note down the proving, so we can take the example to find the distance between any two points. Very simple formula. Question: find AB if A minus 3, 4 and B 7, 2. I'm not the taking the question or anything. We have to mind it and we write the question. So solution AB formula x2 minus x1 plus y2 minus y1 whole square. That your choice, you can take either the first formula, second formula, because both formula same. X2 means, if you confuse, write x1 y1 x2 y2. So 7 minus x1 whole square. y2 minus y1 whole square with square root. Then 7 plus 3 whole square, 2 minus 4 minus 2 whole square, 10 square plus 4, 100 plus 4, 104. Then find the square root. 2 5s are 10, 2 2s are 226, 213. So 2 into 2 into 2 into 13. So 2 root 26 unit is the distance of AB. We square it, can't solve, so write. You can say, sir, why you not take the positive negative both sign? We always say square root give both value, plus minus plus minus plus minus, but here the distance, and distance can never be negative, so we can't take the negative sign, only take positive sign. So our answer is 2 root 26 is the distance between AB. Pause the video, note down. Suppose we say x axis, y axis, here is a point xy P, this is the origin, and the question say find the distance of P from origin. Distance of P from origin. So OP, this is x1 y1 and this is x2 y2. So x1 minus x2 whole square, y1 minus y2 whole square, you get x square plus y square. So here we have to use the formula of distance formula, this, but you can directly use distance from origin. So d is equal to square root x square plus y square. This is also a distance formula. Means, if take example, what is the distance from origin of point minus 3, minus 4? So d is equal to x square plus y square minus 3 square minus 4 square, 9 plus 16, that is 25 unit is the distance from the origin, that is the distance formula. ओके, पॉज द वीडियो, नो डाउन, सो वी कैन रफ ऑल द थिंग्स, डिस्टेंस फॉर्मूला एंड द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम ओरिजिन. If I say find the distance between -3, 0 and 0, -4, so same x1, y1, x2, y2. Solution: distance x1 - x2 whole square plus y1 - y2 whole square is square root, -3 - 0 whole square, 0 - -4 whole square, -3 square plus 4 square, 9 + 16 = 25. 5. Same only formula use. Some small mistakes you have to done. So remember, if I write -a - b whole square, that means a + b whole square. If -a + b whole square, you can write a - b whole square or b - a whole square. All threes are equal without any problem. Okay, so don't be confused that you have direct use this concept to solve the question in easier way. Pause the video and note down.